Question is, the principal value of tan inverse minus 1 is? Options are 45 degree, 135 degree, minus 45 degree, minus 60 degree. See, we know that if the function is y is equal to tan inverse x, then its principal value lies between minus pi by 2 to pi by 2. Here it is minus pi by 2. Here angle is 0 and here it is pi by 2. These values are not included because we know that at 10 pi by 2, the value of the function is infinity. So these values are not included. It lies between minus pi by 2 and pi by 2. Now, here the value of tan inverse minus 1 is to be found. So let us say that this value is equal to theta. So this gives us tan theta is equal to minus 1. Now, from this we find that if the theta is minus 45 degree, if this angle is 45 degree, here it is there in the clockwise direction, it is in the negative direction of theta. So if the angle is like this, then the value of this function will be minus 1. So here option C is correct. Tan inverse minus 1 is minus 45 degree. Next question is 2 tan inverse 1 by 2 equals. These are the options given to us. Here we see that the options are, all options are in the cos inverse form. Means we are to convert tan inverse into cos inverse. Now, the formula we know that 2 tan inverse x is equal to cos inverse 1 minus x square upon 1 plus x square. This is the convergent formula we know from inverse trigonometry. So here we use this formula. X is there as 1 upon 2. So 2 tan inverse 1 by 2 will be equal to cos inverse 1 minus x square, that is 1 upon 2 square, which is 1 upon 4, upon 1 plus x square, that is 1 upon 4. It is to be simplified. We get cos inverse 3 by 4 upon 5 by 4. 4 and 4 are cancelled. We get cos inverse 3 upon 5. So here option A is correct. Value of this function is cos inverse 3 upon 5. Question is, if tan inverse 3 by 4 is equal to theta, then sin theta is equal to, these are the four options given to us. We have been given tan inverse 3 upon 4 equal to theta. So this gives us tan theta is equal to 3 upon 4. With the definition of inverse function, we can write that tan theta is equal to 3 upon 4. Now make right angle triangle. It is 90 degree. This angle is theta. Now if the perpendicular is 3 and base is 4, then tan theta is equal to 3 upon 4. Obviously, using Pythagoras theorem, we can find that hypotenuse will be 5. So sin theta will be 3 upon 5. So therefore, sin theta, which is perpendicular upon hypotenuse, is 3 upon 5. Here, option B is the correct option. Next question is, the value of cot of tan inverse alpha plus cot inverse alpha is? Options are 1, infinity, 0, none of these. See, what is written in the big bracket is tan inverse alpha plus cot inverse alpha. And we have the inverse trigonometric formula that tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is equal to pi by 2. So here, this value is pi by 2. So expression becomes cot of pi by 2. And we know that cot 90 degree is equal to 0. So here option C is the correct option. We have used the formula cot inverse x, tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is equal to pi by 2 here. and obtained the value of the expression as 0. Question is, if sine inverse 1 upon 2 is equal to x, then the general value of x is. These are the four options given to us. See, we have been given sine inverse 1 upon 2 is equal to x. With the definition of inverse function, we can write that sine x is equal to 1 upon 2. Now, we know that if x is pi by 6, that is 30 degree, then value of sine 30 degree is 1 upon 2. So, here x is equal to pi by 6 or 30 degree. Now, in question, we want the general value of x. So, this option is not correct. Now, we want the general value. Now, we have seen in the previous class in trigonometric equations that if sine theta is equal to sine alpha, then theta is equal to, the general value of theta is n pi plus minus 1 raised to the power n into alpha. Using this formula, we can write that general value of x will be equal to n pi plus minus 1 raised to the power n pi by 6. So here option D is the correct option. Question is, the value of 2 tan within bracket tan inverse x plus tan inverse x cube is, and these are the four options given to us. First we will be solving this bracket. Now bracket is of the form tan inverse x plus tan inverse y, and we have the formula of tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is equal to tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy. This we have seen in inverse trigonometry. So using this formula, we can write the bracket quantity tan inverse x plus tan inverse x cube will be equal to tan inverse x plus x cube upon 1 minus x into x cube. Simplifying this, this gives us tan inverse x plus x cube upon 1 minus x to the power 4. This we can write. Now, this value, the expression will be 2 tan. Here we write tan inverse of x plus x cube upon 1 minus x to the power 4. Now tan into tan inverse, tan is cancelled. So we get 2 times x plus x cube upon 1 minus x to the power 4. अब हम इसको सरल करते हैं. तो मान कितना हो गया, 2 x कॉमन ले लिया, ये हो गया 1 plus x square. ब्रैकेट में इसको गुणनखंड किए तो 1 plus x square into 1 minus x square. 1 plus x square से 1 plus x square कैंसिल हो गया, तो मान आ गया 2 x upon 1 minus x square. अर्थात यहां विकल्प A सही विकल्प है. Question is, if tan inverse 3x plus tan inverse 2x is equal to pi by 4, then x is equal to, options are 1 by 6, 1 by 3, 1 by 10, 1 by 2. See, this is left hand side is of the form tan inverse x plus tan inverse y. And we have the formula of inverse trigonometry that tan inverse x plus tan inverse y is equal to tan inverse x plus y upon 1 minus xy. This formula we know, and use this formula in the left hand side. So the equation becomes tan inverse 3x plus 2x upon 1 minus 3x into 2x. This is equal to pi by 4, which gives us tan inverse 5x upon 1 minus 6x square is equal to pi by 4. So tan pi by 4 is this value. So this gives us tan pi by 4
is equal to 5x upon 1 minus 6x square.
Now 10 pi by 4, that is 10 45 degree, we know is 1. So this gives us 5x upon 1 minus 6x square is equal to 1, which gives us, cross multiplying, 1 minus 6x square is equal to 5x, that is 6x square plus 5x minus 1 is equal to 0. Factorize this, 6 into 1 is 6, so split this middle term in such a way that the subtraction will give us 5, means 6 and 1 are the two factors. So this gives us 6x square plus 6x minus x minus 1 is equal to 0. 6x can be taken common, x plus 1 will be in the bracket, minus taken common, x plus 1, this is equal to 0. This implies x plus 1, 6x minus 1 is equal to 0. Therefore, x will be minus 1 or 1 upon 6.
If x plus 1 is equal to 0, then x is minus 1. If 6x minus 1 is equal to 0, then x is 1 upon 6.
Now, if x is a negative quantity, then this will be negative and this will be negative. And that value cannot give us pi by 4. So, negative value we can straight away reject. So this gives us the value of x as 1 upon 6. Acceptable value of x is 1 upon 6. Option A here is the correct answer. Question is, the value of sine inverse root 3 by 2 plus 2 times cos inverse root 3 by 2 is? Options are pi by 2, pi by 3, 2 pi by 3, pi. See, we do not have the formula of sine inverse x plus 2 times cos inverse x. We do not have direct formula. But we observe in this question that this first expression, the first term is sine inverse root 3 by 2. So first term, sine inverse root 3 by 2 can be converted into angle. This is equal to, this gives us that this angle suppose is theta, then sine theta is equal to root 3 by 2. And we know that the value of theta should be 60 degree, that is pi by 3. So this gives us theta is equal to pi by 3, that is 60 degree. Sine 60 degree is root 3 by 2. Again in second term, we see it is cos inverse root 3 by 2. So cos inverse root 3 by 2, we know, suppose this is alpha, then cos alpha will be equal to root 3 by 2. And we know that angle should be 30 degree if cos of alpha is root 3 by 2. Cos 30 degree is root 3 by 2. So this gives us alpha is equal to pi by 6. Now the expression is sine inverse root 3 by 2. So theta is pi by 3. So expression will be pi by 3 plus 2 times, this is alpha, so it is pi by 6. Simplifying this gives us, this is equal to pi by 3 plus pi by 3, that is 2 pi by 3. And hence, option C is the correct answer. Question is, if tan inverse 1 plus cos inverse 1 by root 2 is equal to sine inverse x, then the value of x is, options are minus 1, 0, 1, minus 1 by 2. See, we do not have the formula of tan inverse x plus cos inverse x or cos inverse y. We do not have the formula of it. But here we observe that tan inverse 1 is there, value of which we know. So we know that tan inverse 1 is pi by 4 because tan 45 degree is 1. Similarly, we know the value of cos inverse 1 by root 2. This value, this angle should be 45 degree, that is pi by 4. So, we can put these values here. So, the equation becomes pi by 4 plus pi by 4 is equal to sine inverse x.
This gives us pi by 2 is equal to sine inverse x. Using inverse trigonometric rule, we can write that sine pi by 2 is equal to x. And we know that sine 90 degree is equal to 1. Therefore, x is equal to 1. Option C here is the correct option. Question is, if cot inverse x plus tan inverse 1 by 3 is equal to pi by 2, the value of x is? Options are 1, 3, 1 by 3, none of these. See, we recall that tan inverse x plus cot inverse x, if this is equal to pi by 2, is a formula that we know the formula is for tan inverse x plus cot inverse x is equal to pi by 2. This is our inverse trigonometric formula. If we compare these two, we find that here in place of x, 1 by 3 is written. Otherwise, both the things are same. So here, x should be equal to 1 upon 3. Comparing these two, we find that here it should be x. If it is x, then 1 by 3 should be there. Then this value should be pi by 2. So option C here is the correct option.